So today I am on IUDP Expedition 317 offshore New Zealand on the Canterbury Basin. The goal of Expedition 317 is to drill through a clastic sequence to understand the control on the sequence stratigraphic architecture of the sediments offshore New Zealand. So that's a perfect expedition for us to try to understand system tracts and the details of sequence stratigraphy. So by now you're familiar with the models, the dinosaur flow models, and you also have some understanding of the basic of sequence stratigraphy. So what we're going to do now is we're going to look at a slightly more complex dinosaur flow model, one where we have two full sea level cycles, so two sequences. And then we're going to dissect those sequences and look at the system tracts within those sequences. Are you ready? So let's look at this model. Okay, so here we have this ramp situation again, very similar to before. Notice that we have sand accumulating, sea level goes down at first, and then sea level goes back up. Don't worry, the movie will loop, so we'll have a chance to look at it again. So that's the second cycle, sea level goes down, and then sea level goes back up again. So two full sequences. Let's have a look at this again. Pay attention to where sea level is. Look at the sand going down, and then going back up. Now we're at the high stand, and now sea level goes back down. So the goal for us will be to dissect this model and look in detail at the different sequences that we find inside. So the goal for us will be to use this numerical model to be able to dissect it and look at the different sequences, but also, very importantly, look at the system tracts inside this model. So we're going to take that slowly, step by step. First, let's look at the different facies that we have in the model. So if we start with the facies, we have this orange facies, which is a sandstone. It's a continental sandstone. So one way to represent this would be a river system, a braided river system with lots of sand being deposited. So when you see that color orange, that's the type of environment of deposition you should imagine in your model. The next facies is the beach facies. So that's really where sea meets land, and you have this high energy interface where you have wave action essentially sifting away the finer particle and concentrating the sand. That's the strand line. Those are the beaches. You're familiar with those concepts in sedimentology. And of course, sedimentology is fundamental to a good understanding of stratigraphy. So here we have those sands. So this yellow color that you will see in the model is representative of the sand deposit, this point bar, this high energy environment. Then we have the reworked sandstone. So that's when the sands are being entrained deeper into the system. Now, because those are sand that were basically deposited in shallow water condition, but then reworked deeper, they're less pure. They're mixed with more clays. So that's what this color represents. Pinkish color represents those reworked sandstone. Now let's look at the clay-rich deposits. So these are actually much deeper into the system, and they represent quiescent depositional environment where we essentially have mud being deposited in deeper water below the fairweather wave base. So I've shown you the model in 3D, but sometimes 3D actually adds complexity, especially for a model like this one, which is a simple ramp where the third dimension really doesn't add much interest. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take a slice through this model, and we'll be able to look at the architecture of the deposits a bit better. So I'll show you the same movie that I showed you before, but this time as a cross section. So again, we start with this ramp situation here. The blue line represents sea level. Notice the yellow facies, that's the beach deposit. In the back, we have the orange facies, that's the continental deposit. And see how this yellow facies follows sea level, because it represents essentially deposition at wave base.